this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create and animate this phone scroll animation. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. In most of my tutorials, I try out the animation before, then recreate it while recording. Not this time though. I've got a rough idea how I want things to look like, but nothing else. These are all my notes. So let's see where this is going. We'll use some help to create the hands and phone with a few shapes and finally get the animations right. I wanted to have kind of a template, and as I'm using my phone to record this, I used a piece of cardboard. I thought this would help to get the proportions and movements right. Let's begin with a new comp, adding the footage and finding a nice frame. Yes, beautiful. With no layer selected, we grab the rounded rectangle tool and create the shape of the phone. Stroke width, 4 pixels. Color, cyan. Fill color, black. We open the rectangle path property and set the roundness to around 50. Let's name the layer. Can't type today. Phone front. We duplicate it, move it below, and name it phone back. Then position it, like move it down using the arrow keys. With no layer selected, we choose the rectangle tool this time and create a shape for the part we want the feet to be visible. No stroke, and we need the fill to be white, cause we're going to use it as a mask. Let's create a post. We add a square shape, like a picture. No fill. Stroke width 4 pixels. And let's name the layer post. Then let's use the ellipse tool to add a profile picture, a round shape. It needs some more space, so let's move the pick down. All right. Let's add some lines using the pen tool. Next, let's add a square object below the picture. Actually, we want all the shapes to be in the same layer. So we copy and paste it to the bottom shape and delete the new one. We duplicate the square and move it to the right. Add another round shape and move it over to the right corner. Then we use the pen tool again to add 2 more lines at the bottom. Awesome. Next, we go to layer in the top menu and pre-compose it. Name it pre-post. Then we go into the pre-comp, open the comp settings and adjust the size. Let's try 800 for the height. And let's set the width to 600. Okay, we move the shapes back to the center. Let's narrow it down even more. Height 700. Width 500. Awesome. Let's go back to the main comp and readjust the position. Then we duplicate the pre-comp 5 times until we have a feed of 6 posts aligned. We select them and pre-compose them again. Let's name the comp pre-feed. We go into that pre-comp and adjust the size again. Let's set the width to 600 pixels. And center the position again. We change the height to 5000 pixels. That should be enough. Let's zoom out here. Perfect. Let's go back into the main comp and readjust the position there. Finally, we move it below the mask layer and set track mat to luma mat. Awesome. Let's animate the feet. We open the position property and start at the top with the first post. And set a position keyframe at the beginning. Then we go to maybe 25 frames and move it down a bit. We open the graph editor to edit the speed graph and slow down the end and the beginning of the animation. Let's see. Too fast, so we move the second keyframe further back and adjust the speed curve. That's better. Let's move the footage to see my hand moving along. The start seems a bit too slow, so let's quickly adjust the speed there. Perfect. Let's go to 65 frames and move the feet further down. Next, we open the graph editor again and kind of recreate the first speed curve. Okay, let's hide the footage for now. It's confusing me. Not too bad, right? Let's go to the end and move the feet down. And to make it a loop, let's try and position the post exactly like in the first frame, which is a bit tricky. I am using the home and end keys to jump between the beginning and end. Then we open the graph editor again and adjust the last speed curve. Awesome. The animation speed is slightly different each time. By the way, if you enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel for new animation and motion design videos every week. Thanks so much, guys. Time to grab the pen tool and add the left hand. We roughly redraw the outline. Name the layer left hand and move it below the phone. No stroke, white fill. Let's zoom in. Open the path property to select the path and adjust the shape. We hide the footage to get the last details right. Then copy the layer and change the fill color into a dark cyan. We name the layer left hand shade. Then we grab the ellipse tool and tell the tool to create masks. We need the rectangle tool actually. And draw a mask over the phone, roughly. Open the mask property to set the mask feather to around 70 pixels. Let's actually darken the fill a bit more. Increase the mask feather and let's shrink the mask a tiny bit. Alright, let's add the black nail. Shall we? We grab the pen tool and draw the rough shape. Then change the fill color into a very dark blue. Then we open the new shape property. Zoom in and adjust the shape of the nail. Here it is. I totally forgot to add the fingers, so let's quickly draw the shape using the pen tool. Change the fill color to white, which we then copy to the shade layer. Adjust the fill color again. Next, we need to adjust the mask shape. Awesome. Finally, the left hand. Then I added the shape of the right hand, but it didn't look that great, to put it nicely. It's the perspective which makes the shape look weird. So I deleted the shape and started all over again. Freehand. Drew the shape, fine-tuned it over and over again. And again. Okay, and a thump, maybe? Sure, here we go. Some final adjustments. Then we set a path keyframe at the beginning and position the hand further down as we want it to swipe up. Then we go to 15 frames and move the hand up, rotate it slightly. Bend the pointer finger to the right and move the thumb slightly. We open the graph editor and adjust the speed of the animation. I think it looks about right. Let's close it again and name the layer hand right. We duplicate the shape and pick the nail color as fill. Then we grab the rectangle tool. Switch to adding masks and add two masks, roughly. Then we fine-tune it and set two mask keyframes. Then we go to the beginning and reposition the two masks. Next, we need to adjust the speed curves and try to get it as close to the path curve as possible. We should have added the nails before animating the hand. Anyways, let's have a look. Next, we need to move the hand back down by copying and pasting the first keyframes. Oh no, We should have linked the path shape of the hand to the nails before. So let's go back to 15 frames and link the bottom path to the upper one. Problem solved. We move on to the right and copy and paste the second keyframes in the timeline. Once again, we open the graph editor and adjust the speed graph. Let's see. Okay. I think it would be good to change the finger shape here for the animation to look more random. Awesome. We copy and paste the keyframes again. To add the next swipe gesture. Alright, now it's about fixing the timing. By moving some keyframes and adjusting the speed curve. The curves all look different, which makes the overall animation much more organic and natural. If the curves would be all the same, it would feel very robotic. One last adjustment to the thumb. And to make it a loop, we copy and paste the first keyframes to the end and adjust the speed curve, of course. It ended up looking pretty much the way I imagined it. That's my process, unfiltered, approaching animations like this. Would you have done things differently? Let me know in the comments below. I'd really appreciate a like and please consider subscribing to my channel for new and original animation and motion design videos every week. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye guys.